we will be creating edible candy versions of some grown-up foods. Miniature versions, if you will. These come in a variety of different foods. They're lots of fun, and the instructions are on the back, but I will walk you through the entire process. Let's make some ramen. Packaging is always so cute. Little pictures of the foods. So I'm going to begin by cutting open this package. If you choose to use your package as a display, then you would like to put it to the side at this time and hang on to it. Or you may choose to keep it as a little trash bag. The instructions say to cut the tray apart into sections, so I will begin by doing that. You want to be very careful when reading these instructions because you won't be cutting out these for every single box that you do. Sometimes the boxes will ask you to only cut out one section. Sometimes you will cut out different shapes, and then sometimes you will disassemble the entire package as shown here. So you really should read and reread and make sure that you are following the instructions. We are going to make mango pudding. We're going to add water to this cup till it is half full. I will do this using my syringe here. If you don't have a syringe, that's fine. You can just add water from a small cup or whatever you have. It's nearly halfway full. Next, I will add this mango pudding powder. This particular pudding takes 10 minutes to set up. So I will give it a nice stir and set it aside to let it begin the setup process. All of these candies are technically edible, and they all are the flavors that they say they are. And now we will make our toppings for our ramen. One is this crazy little design here, and one is a boiled egg design. We're going to fill the water to this fill line. Next, we will add the powder. Now let's stir and create a nice thick dough. With each item that you stir, you will realize that there are many different consistencies and textures. This one smells delicious. Smells very sugary and sweet. Once you've gotten a nice mix, you can feel free to set down your utensil and begin to roll the dough with your fingertips if you'd rather. I will remove two small bits, and I'll set this dough to the side. Now I will use use my mold. The box says that this is called a Naruto, N-A-R-U-T-O. Very interesting. Finished product has a little bit of a rough edge. You'll need to use your fingertips to trim it a bit, and I would set it to the side to allow it to harden just a bit more. Next, we will take our remaining dough and cut it in 2/4. And we'll take this little mold here, and we'll take one of the doughs, and let's flatten out one of these pieces of dough. Place it into this small mold here. Gently with your fingers. Take your time so that it doesn't stick to anything. Next, we will place this filling inside of our little dumpling here. Just sprinkle a bit in there. I think that may be enough. Maybe a bit more. And now I will close the mold firmly. It's attached. I will remove the excess dough. Set it to the side here. And there's your little dumpling. And you've got enough dough to make a few of these if you'd like. Now you can take one of your balls of dough. Gently roll it. Flatten it out a bit to make a nice spring roll. This is very simple. You'll just flatten it out and add some of the filling that you added into your dumpling. You can choose one color, or you can do both. I think I'll actually use both colors. Gives it a little variety. Then you simply roll it. Now once I've rolled my spring roll, if I don't see any filling on the sides, I can go back in and add some to the sides to make it just a little prettier. And that's a lot more festive. And now we will make our ramen. We are going to begin by adding water to the fill line inside of this plastic cup here. Next, we will add this powder that is going to make our soup. Just stir it a bit. Next, I will pour water up to the fill line in this tray. Now, I will add this yellow noodle powder to the water. Like I've got a nice solid mix, very even, smells delicious. Next, I will take this plastic bag and this tiny toothpick, and I will go inside of the bag. And I will make a small hole by piercing the corner of the bag. Next, I will fold down the sides of the top of the bag to allow me easy access to apply my yellow mix. Next, I twist the bag and get it ready to make some ramen noodles. As you see, I have trimmed my container into the shape of a nice ramen bowl, and I will now begin creating ramen. By gently squeezing. This is creating tiny bits of candy. And I'll leave just a little bit behind. And the reason is I will use it in the hollow of my egg from before. And that, of course, is going to be a garnish. Don't forget the little Naruto. Now I will need to remove my mango pudding from before. Now, I've got so much extra dough, I could make as many dumplings and as many spring rolls as I want, but I think I'll just stick with what I have. And since I've got this beautiful filling inside of my dumpling, I'll go ahead and cut it open and leave it kind of on display here. I think that's a nice way to do it. And maybe even open it this way. And there you have it. You've got a nice little meal here, and completely edible if you are into candy miniatures. And this is Tanoshi ramen. With mango pudding, gyoza dumpling, spring roll, and ramen noodle soup. This is Tanoshi waffle. Again, really, really cute packaging as usual. With some dough powders for the waffles, watermelon cream powder, cranberry jelly powder, blueberry sauce powder, some sprinkles, plastic bag, and a spoon. Of course, it comes with the molds and the water container. These make it way easier, so be sure to follow the instructions and be sure to cut out whatever it asks you to cut out. beginning by cutting apart the tray as shown on the back of the box. So to begin making the waffles, we start by adding a full triangle cup of water to this tray with the four-leaf clover. Next, I will add the cream dough powder. This is going to form a nice, kneadable, but firm dough. It smells a lot like waffles already. Waffle syrup. So I will take my waffle mold and place this dough into the mold. Close the mold. Very similar to a waffle iron. Some of the dough will come out onto the sides of the mold. Then you will remove the waffle. You can use your fingers. I like to use a tool. I feel that I get a much better result. And then I place it to the side. And now I will repeat those steps. Two more waffles, one chocolate, and another one like the one we just made. Next, we're going to make cranberries. So we're going to add a full triangle cup of water to this little container here. And then we will add this little packet. And the instructions tell us to mix until it begins to get syrupy. So it is slightly syrupy, I believe. So now we will fill the berry molds with the mixture and we will leave it to become firm within 10 minutes. And the instructions tell us to leave the rest in the tray. Now, while we are waiting for our cranberries, we are going to make watermelon cream. And we will do that by adding, two full triangle cups of water to this tray here. And you may have guessed that we will add the watermelon cream powder. This smells really good. Says watermelon, but I believe it is actually honeydew melon. It's starting to blend together really nicely. Nice and creamy. Now our instructions tell us to remove this large piece of gelatin. We are adding a triangle of water. And mixing in blueberry sauce powder. Well, our little waffle meal is now completed. Our box tells us that It is time for us to decorate our waffles. So, I will place them and begin to decorate. Now, the front of the box shows the watermelon cream being applied as such, and the cranberry jellies, and then drizzled with blueberry sauce. There's a bit of jelly crushed here, and they've also got some sprinkles throughout. But feel free to do it your way. I'm going to take just a little bit of the blueberry sauce. And now we need some sprinkles, of course. Now, I know that you are thinking that this looks like it could be in a 5-star restaurant, right? I would have to agree with you. There you have it. Our beautiful, sweet Tanoshi waffle. And it's got cranberry, it's got watermelon, or as I call honeydew, it's got chocolate, buttercream, it's got a little bit of everything, and I hope that you are able to follow along and let me know if you actually tasted it. I don't actually eat any of these creations, but I would love to hear if any of you actually do eat them, because they are indeed edible. Let's try this vanilla and strawberry ice cream. As you can see, they have provided a plastic version of a tray and a little display area if you choose to use it. And all of the instructions are on the back. So, we will remove all of the packages gently, place them where we can see them, We will use scissors to remove the triangle cup, which we will use for water measurement throughout the process. So now I will add powder from the pink and blue packets to the two sections of the tray, according to these instructions. This one is vanilla powder. First. Make sure to get every bit of the powder in there. Next, we will use the strawberry cream powder. Perfect. Now we will add a full triangle cup of water into each section and mix well using a spoon until creamy. Next, we will do the other side. Very thick and creamy. It's a nice texture. It's a beautiful color as well. Next, I'll take this squeezing bag and I will add the cream to the bag. Using these indicators, the red for the strawberry, obviously. light. Now you have strawberry and vanilla. You will gently twist. Now we will use our scissors on the dotted line. You want to express the cream down to the tip. Now we will begin to fill our ice creams. Here is a simple ice cream cone. You can simply fill it. Now that one is quite unique, to say the least. Now, you may also choose to forego the ice cream cones and place cream in wafers. And we've got plenty of cream left, should you choose to do that. You can also use this nice little cone dish. It's made kind of like a waffle cone dish. You can fill that however you like. And then you can apply the sprinkles however you'd like. Not terrible.